You want me to talk about him? Okay.
Well, we were all naked upstairs and we're all the same sex, basically.
Yeah.
Girls used to do everything with him. I know you can't really say that, but
he doesn't just, like, wash, so people, you can always smell it on
him. He stunk a lot of times.
Yeah.
But he liked the ugly girls.
Yeah.
He liked that power.
Yeah. You could stick his legs around his head.
He was like one of those gummy dolls.
I know him pretty well. Every Sunday night he'd come over and he'd, you know, we'd smoke pot. He'd giggle and tickle me. He'd tickle me here. Sometimes he would grab like the inside of my thigh. I wouldn't really feel good the next day. I don't know why, but I don't want to talk about this anymore.
No, I see him,
well, I shouldn't say I saw him because I didn't actually see him myself, but a friend of a friend of a friend, of a friend, of a friend, of a friend,
of a friend, of a friend,
of sort of a friend of a friend, of a friend, of a friend, of a friend, who of someone who is a friend of someone.
He had this way of making you feel like a pile of stinky feces. I am nothing. It's hard being friends.
No, he's daunting when you first meet him, because he's huge, he's massive. And he's a scary person when you first meet him, but he's a good guy.
He just brings out the devil in me. He makes me want to do things that I would never even dream of doing. One time he made me cut myself. I loved it. It was the most exciting thing I'd ever done.
Anybody, it didn't matter if you were a boy or a girl, he just, a hole was a hole for him.
He'd go to like give you a high five or a handshake and he'd just crush your hand.
Curb stomped him.
He actually slept with my sister, and he slept with my mom, and he slept with my dad. And he fucked my cousin, fucked my sister, and he fucked me.
Look who's here.
Is he here?
What's up, dude?